Online misogyny is a global gender rights tragedy, and it is imperative that it ends.
Oh, fuck. Ashley Judd went on TED Talks and gave a speech on her experiences in social media, as well as her views on the gaming industry and how she believes that it is just rampant with sexist, misogynistic men. So I thought I'd make this video and counter her shit arguments.
Girls and women's voices and our allies' voices. Girls and women's voices and our allies' voices. And our allies' voices. Allies' voices. Allies.
Allies. Allies.
See, the thing is that in her feminist-type cult, they can't even acknowledge that the men who buy into these same sort of ideals are even worthy of being acknowledged. They have to use a term like ally. They can't refer to them as men. They can't do that, because that would be acknowledging men doing something right. And slow your roll, buddy. You just an ally. You're not actually doing anything. You're not actually benefiting anyone by doing this. Just sit down, shut up, be subservient, and we'll get the problems taken care of ourselves.
I am a Kentucky basketball fan, so on a fine March day last year, I was doing one of the things I do best. I was cheering for my Wildcats. The daffodils were blooming, but the referees were not blowing the whistle when I was telling them to. Funny, they're very friendly to me before the opening tip, but they really ignore me during the game. Three of my players were bleeding, so I did the next best thing. I tweeted.
The thing that Ms. Judd is failing to recognize is that when you go on a public forum and you're expressing some sort of opinionated bullshit, like I'm doing right now, you open yourself to criticism. Now, I'm not saying that, you know, because she got a lot of rape threats and death threats and all, and I'm not condoning any of that. If you could catch people like that, I would be totally in favor of, you know, reprimanding them in some way. Especially if the threat is credible. But either way. But the thing is you go on a public forum and you speak your mind. Someone else, therefore, has the right to speak their mind. If you go to Walmart and stand on a soapbox, someone can ridicule your thoughts. You know, it's a public forum. You're in public. You don't want to hear other opinions, then maybe don't post in some sort of public forum.
It is routine for me to be treated in the ways I've already described to you. It happens to me every single day on social media platforms such as Twitter and Facebook.
A lot of these feminists, a lot of these activists from today, they have this victimhood mentality. It's almost like this victimhood is a currency for them. It's really fucking backwards ass fucking shit. You know? Everybody that goes online, that puts their ideas out there, is open to the most vile bullshit and being judged on the merits of their thoughts. No one is exempt from that experience online.
Since I joined Twitter in 2011, misogyny and misogynists have amply demonstrated they will dog my every step. My spirituality, my faith, being a hillbilly, I can say that, you can't, all of it is fair game.
That's exactly fucking right. If you want to go on your fucking page and you want to say some bullshit about, you know, you're only this if you this, you're going to go to hell if you do that, or you spout some stupid bullshit about your religion, you open yourself up to people that have different religions that disagree with your religions that are going to call you out and say that you're wrong and that you're going to hell instead. And you're going to have people who don't believe at all saying that it's a complete waste of fucking time, or don't judge me, you fucking hypocrite, or, you know, something like that. And you're going to find them all as hate speech, as violence. It's bullshit. You get to say what you want to say, and then you judge others because they disagree with you. It's bullshit. Now, if you would just count the people that are sending you threats, rape threats, death threats, it would be one thing. But you lot, everyone together, as being racist, violent, misogynistic, it's bullshit. It's a way for you never to face any sort of criticism at all.
Allies.
And then to top it all off, you're a feminist and you're Christian. Christianity, the Bible that says that women are here for the enjoyment of men. I mean, don't you find that the least bit hypocritical? At least for a feminist? For a feminist? Really?
This one guy was musing to I don't know who, that maybe I was the definition of a cunt. I was married to a Scot for 14 years, so I said, cunt means many different things in different countries. But I'm pretty sure you epitomize the global standard of a dick.
Listen to that crowd reaction. Now, she's trying to imply that it's sexist to call a woman a cunt, but yet she and the crowd has no problem with calling a man a dick. That's not sexist at all. That's not a double standard. That's not hypocritical. That's not bullshit, right? Right?
I've tried to rise above it. I've tried to get in the trenches, but mostly I would scroll through these social media platforms with one eye partially closed, trying not to see it, but you can't make a cucumber out of a pickle. What is seen goes in. It's traumatic.
She used the word traumatic. She just used the word traumatic. So, okay, I realize you've been a victim of real things in your life, okay? But what you're saying is that these words are equal to those traumatic experiences. They cause trauma. And it's bullshit. Soldiers that went and experienced real violence come back and they have PTSD and they have real problems. And people are not getting PTSD from a fucking tweet. And the fact that you have been a real victim several times, according to yourself, that should be obvious to you. Are you really going to say your real experiences are equal to some fucking tweet? It's fucking bullshit. Fuck!
Because even I, an avowed, self-declared feminist who worships at the altar of Gloria...
At least we can agree that it's basically a religion for you. At least we can agree on that.
On that particular day, for some reason, that particular tweet after the basketball game triggered something called a cyber mob. This vitriolic, global outpouring of the most heinous hate speech. Death threats, rape threats.
But you know, the thing is, you didn't just silence people who were being vitriolic or vile, threatening. You were silencing anyone with a dissenting opinion. And that's the common problem amongst your ilk.
So I wrote this feminist op-ed. It is entitled, Forget Your Team. It is your online gender violence toward girls and women that can kiss my righteous ass.
Notice how it's only girls and women.
Girls and women.
Girls and women. Girls and women. Girls and women.
You know, violence against men is not even a concern. That's okay. But the thing that I want to stress is what you just said can kiss your righteous ass. To some people, to a lot of people in this country who are more wholesome or whatever, I would say hypocritical, but whatever, there are some people in this country that would be offended by the type of speech that you just used. And that goes to a larger point here, which is, who is going to be this arbiter? Who watches the watchman? Who is going to decide what is offensive speech? What is hate speech? What should be prosecuted?
And I did that alone, and I published it alone, because my chief advisor said, please don't. The rain of retaliatory garbage that is inevitable, I fear for you. But I trust girls, and I trust women, and I trust girls, and I trust women, and I trust girls, and I trust women, and I trust our allies, allies, allies,
allies, allies.
It was published, it went viral, it proves that every single day, online misogyny is a phenomenon endured by us all.
Oh, you got it so close right there. You got it so close right there. Oh man, if you would have just minus the misogyny part and said, we are all subjected to ridicule when we put our thoughts online, it would have been one of the first correct statements you actually fucking made.
When it is intersectional, it is worse.
Now, this intersectional shit she's talking about, what she's trying to say is that, let's say someone is saying some mean comments, and mean can mean any fucking thing from rape threats to, hey, I don't think those are pretzels, I think those are Cheetos. You know, just simply disagreeing with someone is considered fucking hate to these people. So, what they're saying is, let's say it's a white person doing it, or a white man, a white male, doing it to a Latino person, a Latino female. Well, that's inherently wrong. That's more wrong, because it's happening to a minority. Now, versus the exact same thing, just roles reversed, that's not as bad. Intersectionality is worse for reasons, apparently. It's not the same thing. It doesn't translate the same.
I actually pay someone to scrub my social media feeds, attempting to spare my brain the daily iterations of the trauma of hate speech. And guess what? I get hate speech for that. Oh, you live in an echo chamber. Well, guess what? Having someone post a photograph of me with my mouth open saying they can't wait to come on my face, I have a right to set that boundary.
You absolutely do have a right to set that fucking boundary. Absolutely. We can all agree that those type of comments are pretty fucking disgusting and wrong. But that's not all that you fucking remove. You remove any sort of dissenting opinion. You lot them all together as hate. Okay? So when there is literally no dissenting opinion being able to be uttered, that is the definition of a fucking echo chamber. All right? And listen to this fucking moron in the background going, thank you. All right, listen to what she says right here.
But you know what we do? We take all of this hate speech and we disaggregate it and we code it and we give that data so that we understand the intersectionality of it. You know, when I get porn, when it's about political affiliation, when it's about age, when it's about all of it. We're gonna win this fight.
Okay, so political affiliation, religion, spiritual belief, all of that bullshit, we're not allowed to comment when you are commenting yourself on these subjects. So I guess the next time someone's running for office, I guess we can't disagree or voice our opinions because violence, hate speech, misogynistic bullshit buzzwords, and it's hate. It's hate speech. What kind of fucking backwards ass bullshit? What kind of person listens to this bullshit and is like, yup, that's it, you know, that makes sense to us. The government should fucking control what we're able to fucking say.
Shall we talk about our friends in tech? Said with dignity and respect, the sexism in your workplaces must end. Only when women have critical mass in every department at your companies, including building platforms from the ground up, will the conversations about priorities and solutions change.
According to this woman, we should have some equality of outcome rather than the best person for the job gets the job. No, fuck that. Fuck competitive environments. We need equal gender, equal race at every level. At every level. So it doesn't matter how hard you work. It doesn't matter your education levels. None of that matters. What matters is equality of outcome. And that is the only time where people can be capable of making any sort of change for the better.
And more love for my friends in tech. Profiteering off misogyny and video games must end. I'm so tired of hearing you talk to me at cocktail parties, like you did a couple weeks ago in Aspen, about how deplorable hashtag Gamergate was when you're still making billions of dollars off games that maim and dump women for sport.
Okay, so she's obviously talking about GTA games and the like, right? So that's all that's happening in these games is women dying for sport, women, you know, being victimized, women being sexualized for sport. It's not, you know, men at all. It doesn't happen. You know, we don't have games like fucking Gears of War where men are these fucking hulking, you know, burly fucking men. Every comic book isn't, you know, these fucking ripped fucking people. And you know, by extension, the comic book characters in the video games, every fucking man that is portrayed in any sort of fucking media is these ripped fucking guys, and it's not fucking happening the other way around? Seriously? What fucking planet do you fucking live on? Since the early Nintendo, we've had women represented in video games.
Basta.
Pasta?
Basta.
Basta?
Basta.
Basta.
Basta, as the Italians would say. Enough!
Did you just appropriate Italian culture? Isn't that hypocritical of your ideology? Just saying.
Our friends in law enforcement have much to do because we've seen that online violence is an extension of in-person violence.
So you want to prosecute? And where do you draw the line on that? You view any dissenting opinion as hate speech. So you say, hey, I'm gonna have pizza tonight, and someone says, well, pizza fucking sucks. Under your fucking thought process, that person should be prosecuted by police? I mean, I really want to fucking know these things, because you block people that even say something as simple as that. Any dissenting fucking opinion. And it's the same fucking thing. I disagree with you on your politics. I disagree with you on your pizza. It's the same fucking thing.
In our country, more girls and women have been murdered by their intimate partners then died on 9/11 and have died since in Afghanistan and Iraq combined. And it's not cool to say that, but it is true.
You know what else is true? Almost double the men as women die as a result of injury and homicide. Almost double the men in relation to women in comparison to women, right? Homicide, suicide, and, you know, automobile accidents, leading cause of men dying. But you don't want to talk about suicide rate with men being so elevated in comparison to women. No, that's a men's issue, right? So we can't talk about that, right? How about, let's talk about the rate to which boys in this country, in the United States of America, are sexually assaulted, sexually molested by teachers, by female teachers. And then not only do the teachers, the female teachers, practically skate, even if they go to jail, they go to jail at such a disproportionate rate to what a man would face if they were, you know, convicted of the same crime. Can you imagine in this country if a male teacher was to molest one of his female students, and then that teacher only got a fraction of the sentence that they normally get for this type of offense? But like I said, not only that, but if the boy student, he could be 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, doesn't matter. If he's a boy and he complains, he feels like he was raped, he feels like he was taken advantage of, he has PTSD, then he's labeled a faggot because there's no way he didn't enjoy it, right? He's labeled a faggot because how could he not enjoy being raped, molested by, you know, a teacher, someone he's supposed to trust? But you don't want to talk about that either, right? That doesn't exist, right?
Our legislators must write and pass astute legislation that reflects today's technology and our notions of free and hate speech.
So let me get this straight. You want politicians in a fucking time where we're so fucking divided, we've never been so fucking divided other than the civil fucking war, right? Politicians, the approval ratings for politicians are so fucking low, historically fucking low, and you want these people who we don't trust to be the fucking arbiters of what we can say? Are you batshit insane? What kind of regime would they have if you aren't allowed to ridicule it? Because that's counted as hate speech. What the fuck would happen then? Are you fucking out of your mind? What the fuck is wrong with you?
So apparently, I've got a pretty bold voice. So let's talk about our friends. White men.
Right, because a growing trend in America right now is white males, it's like a new religion right now. Being a white male is like being born with original sin. Get it? You know, from the womb, you're flawed, you're fucked. You're a piece of shit, right? That's not fucking racist. That's not racist at all.
We're cool in this room, but when this goes out, everyone will say, oh my God, she's a reverse racist.
There's no such thing as reverse racism. There's only racism. Racism isn't contingent upon the struggles of one race versus the struggles of another race. Racism is contingent upon feeling better, feeling elite in comparison to another race. Like the way that you view white males as being inherently privileged. We're automatically privileged. We're automatically shit lords. You know, worse than people. You view us as beneath you. You're morally superior to us. I would view that as racism. How can you not see that, you fucking racist?
And lastly, believe her. Believe her.
Because it wouldn't be a feminist speech without mentioning the whole listen and believe bullshit, right? Because, you know, if my memory serves, it didn't happen recently multiple times where a woman just decided to try and ruin a man's life and succeeded at ruining a man's life by making being harassed, being stalked, being raped, being beaten. That never happens, right? See, that's why in this country you are innocent until proven guilty. But what you imply is guilty until proven innocent. Why are all of your fucking viewpoints ass backwards? They're just ass backwards. We cannot convict someone with no evidence. We cannot assume someone is guilty unless there's evidence. Okay? Doesn't mean we have to shame the victim. That's not what I'm saying. But we can't just assume and convict someone without having evidence. We prosecute, we execute people that are fucking innocent 4% of the fucking time in this country. And you want to fucking make things worse. It's fucking stupid.
So I'm going to say awesome stuff about myself. I would like for you to reflect it back to me. It might sound something like this. I am a powerful and strong woman, and you would say, yes, you are.
Yes, you are.
My mama loves me.
Yes, she does.
I did a great job with my talk.
Yes, you did.
I have a right to be here.
Yes, you do.
I'm really cute.
Yes, you are.
God does good work.
Yes, he does.
She acknowledged that echo chamber was a thing. She fucking said it earlier in the fucking speech. And that's what they're fucking doing. These subservient fucks are literally echoing her. That's an echo chamber. What the fuck is going on? What is happening? How is there so fucking little that there's just this fucking lack of self-awareness? What the fuck is happening? How can people be this fucking stupid? It's fucking mind-numbingly stupid. They're fucking echoing her fucking thoughts to her. And mind you, a lot of these people are secular. They are either agnostic or atheist. They don't believe in what she fucking believes in. But yet, they fucking sucked her shit down and spit it right back at her. If you listen to it again, there's less people that say that back to her.
Yes, you do.
I'm really cute.
Yes, you are.
God does good work.
I mean, it's easily noticeable. This is fucking nuts. This is crazy. Fuck it. I'm done. I'm done with it. This is fucking stupid. What the fuck, man? All right, that's gonna do it for me. This isn't really my normal type of video. Let me know if this is something you enjoyed, something you want to see more of, less of. This is Trevor over at Top Loaded Gaming saying, fuck third wave feminism.